loves, and welcome back to my channel here in New York, and I will get into the full story time of how it happened, but I know you're probably just here for the unboxing, so we will get into that first. And by the way, if you're new here, hi, my name is Morgan. I make videos about luxury handbags, fashion, and lifestyle, so if that's your thing, please subscribe and turn on notifications. I upload once a week-ish, and I would love to have you here. And let's get into my first Hermes bag that I've ever bought in store. So we did get a few other things, and my love got a few things as well. So I'll get into that after the main unboxing. And while I'm unboxing the smaller things, I'll get into the story time of how I got the bag. Into the unboxing of the main event. I've kept it wrapped. I'm still stunned. Now, it's not a color I've mentioned that was on the top of my wish list, but I knew that if I had my wish list colors, this would not be a color I would say no to. So my Hermes journey is just a little bit out of order in, you know, the colors that I want to have eventually, but I think this is just gorgeous and I can't wait to share it with you. So I want to know what you think the color is. And we have my first Kelly Cellier 28 with palladium hardware in the color Celeste. I know. I was not even having a blue Kelly technically on my wish list because my other Kelly that I bought pre-loved is blue Atoll. But that one is more of a teal color and has more of a green undertone. So when the essay pulled this out and said, you know, it's not exactly what you asked for, but I think you would like the color, he was right. I have been looking for a like true blue bag that's like perfect for a while now. Look at this stunning shade. I mean, she's gonna be in my collection forever, my first in-store offer. So let's go ahead and get this open, take off all the stickers. I'm gonna use it while I'm here in the city. So there we go, there's one. There's three. And there we go. So now you can see like the beautiful shiny hardware. Let me hold it up a little bit closer. I hope that it's coming across. I've wanted a Cellier Kelly for forever. Like, this is my dream style. And the fact that it's in the 28 size, I always thought this would be my perfect size. And as soon as I tried it on, I was like, that's it. From now on, this will be the size that I go for, maybe a mini Kelly one day. But I can tell, like, this is the perfect size for my, like, everyday. Here's the bottom. Let me show you the inside as well. Oh, inside we have the strap and the clochette, but here's what it looks like. We'll be keeping everything in like pouches if I use it before I get an insert. Let me show you everything that comes with it. Got like a little care booklet. Here's the two raincoats. In this dust bag, we have the strap. It's like the thin strap and is just like a shoulder strap. And then we have the clochette as well. It's the lock and the keys. I typically do not keep this on my bag because I don't want to have any scratching. So now that you've seen the bag, let me unbox the other items and give you the full story of how I got my offer in the New York City Meatpacking Hermes store. Here in New York for like 2 weeks, and I was like, you know what? Let me just go see how their stock levels are, and you know, even if there are things on my wish list that maybe I couldn't get in Europe over the summer, what I could find. I genuinely didn't think this would happen. Our first like full day, we were going out shopping. We went into Hermes and we bought two men's sneakers and then two items here for myself. They were short staffed that day. So basically the floor manager actually assisted us because she was taking on clients because they just had, you know, not enough essays for the day. So we were going through the list. First we shopped for the men's shoes. There were two pairs that he wanted. One needed to be ordered back into the store because they didn't have his size. And then the other one we took home that day. Let me start with the big one. And then after that, I was looking at belts. So I had taken my Constant Slim wallet in and said, I just want like a pink belt or a light pastel color belt that I could wear with a Constant Slim. And it'll like look nice, you know, like I wear a lot of color, so I didn't mind mixing colors because 5P pink is a super hard color to find. So I actually ended up going for the Vert Fizz belt. Let me get this open. Now my Constant Slim wallet is a palladium hardware, but I decided to go for the gold and go for something that wasn't an H, that I can wear this mix, like my rings are mixed, so I didn't mind mixing the hardware. And this to me just looked like a detail. And this is the perfect one that if I want to wear it high-waisted or I want to wear it like with my jeans, it fits both. So I typically take an 85 for my high waist, and this one is a 90, and then they can punch up to 3 extra holes, which they do in the store for you. This is what I picked out. You guys know me, I probably will never use this side, but it was the only pastel that worked out, so that's why I went for this. I thought this was a great way to contrast with the constant slim. Let me get the wallet and show you what it looks like with the belt. Are the colors together, and I just thought like green and pink is always like a color combination that I really like. And another thing is like, okay, even if I'm closing it and this buckle is next to it, if I just spin it around, I can just wear it like this with no buckle and like put the buckle in the back of whatever I'm wearing. I'm gonna keep a lookout for the exact match, but I think, that could take me years to find. And then after we finalized the belt, we went downstairs to the jewelry and we finally found something I have been hunting all summer. You guys will know exactly what this is. We found the small ear cuff. I don't even know if it'll show on this iPhone camera. I will take some pictures and put them into the video as well so you can see it closer up. In a bright yellow. And I was like, this is just perfect because I wanted a bright color with gold hardware, and this yellow I just thought was stunning. We went through the whole list. She was like, is there anything else that you wanted to see? And we mentioned that I've been looking for bags. I had mentioned upstairs, we're talking about stock, and I was like, you guys actually have really great stock. We haven't been able to get a lot of things we wanted over the summer. She's like, oh, that's great to hear, you know, because a lot of our clients will say, oh, I'm gonna go to Europe and get it, so I'm not gonna buy it, you know, here in New York, because the prices are higher than in Europe, of course, because you get tax back in Europe when you're a tourist. We kind of were chatting about that, you know, throughout the shopping experience, and I had mentioned I wasn't even able to get like a leather option, even though I'm very open to different shapes. I don't know the full Europe shopping experience I had. I have a video on that, so I'll link it here above. Basically, we were just chatting, and I think she could kind of tell, like, you know, we're buying from different categories. I had a wish list I was working on, and there were things that I love from the brand. At the end of it, after the jewelry, and when I mentioned that I would love a bag, it's like, unfortunately, we don't have anything today, but you can put in your wish list on our system. Asked me if I had a profile, and I said, well, not here, but in many other countries, like across Europe, and I have one in Dubai, but I don't have a profile here in the US. So we created my profile, and this is how I gave my wish list, because I was open. So I said, you know, I've been chasing a Ruli bag in a bright color, preferably gold hardware. And then I also said, I'm looking for a mini Evelyn, either like a bright pink or like the Hermes orange, like the really bright orange. And I'm also looking for a Garden Party 30 in a pastel color, like a pastel pink or a pastel green, something that's just like light and summery. Then I said, am I allowed to put a Kelly on the wish? And she said, yes, you can do that. So I said, well, if I can put a Kelly on there, I would just love a really bright colored Kelly, preferably pink. I mean, that would be my dream bag, in the Cellier style, gold hardware, preferably, but if the color suits with silver hardware, I'm also open to that as well. I said either the size 28 or a mini Kelly. Also asked me, is there anything you don't want? I said, I don't want a neutral bag, and I don't want a color that's like super dark that it leans neutral either. So no like burgundy, navy, super dark green. So she was like, that's really refreshing to hear actually, because most people are asking us, you know, for black or gold. We checked out, and it was two separate transactions because one shoe had to be ordered in. And she said, what I'm gonna do is when shoe comes in, you'll get an email, your appointment time on the request, and I'll pair you with an essay and let them know what you're looking for and how long you're here and everything, because we are here for 2 weeks. I think that's also helpful to know. So the shoe came in on, I believe it was Friday, and we booked the appointment for Saturday morning. Went in to pick up the shoe, and Ronnie tried it on, and the essay we were paired with also asked me, is there anything else we're shopping for? And so I mentioned, I said, well, I think I'm a little early, but if you have any new Oran colors come in, you know, I would love to get some more colors. and also a Kelly belt in pink, preferably with gold hardware. I also said if you, you know, have any bags come in. He said we don't have any bags and we're not gonna get any bags till the end of the year. You know, that set my expectation that, okay, maybe a Kelly belt will come in and I'll get another little thing or something like that. But I'm not getting a bag, they're not coming in. Said, I can see your wish list on the system. If we do have anything come in, I will let you know. So we said, thank you, we left. We went to lunch, we're sitting at lunch and I get a message saying like, I had something special come into the store just as you were leaving and I'd love to show you. I did not know it was going to be a Kelly. Like I genuinely, that was out of my head. I was like, we only bought two shoes, a belt, and an earring. This was my first spend in the US. I didn't think my spend was enough to get a Kelly offer. I think because maybe we bought across different categories. I don't know if they have the authority to, you know, look and see what we spent in other Hermes systems. I don't know if that's connected because I had to make a separate profile here. So if she could have seen what I had spent across the brand, maybe that, had something to do with it. The SA had to get approval from the floor manager to offer me this bag. She was the one we originally shopped with. So I don't know if she has some access to that or not. Like I genuinely don't know. Maybe it's because we were in the meatpacking store and I don't know if they have back rooms or whatever, but he even like sat us down in like the fine jewelry section. I'm really, even then, still not thinking it's a Kelly offer. Cause I was like, oh, if they give you a Kelly, they take you to the back and like, you know, they don't want other people to see or, you know, whatever it is. And when he opened it and he said, it's not the color you asked for, but I think you're gonna like the color. I was like, okay, it's gonna be another bag that I'm gonna reject. Like, cause I have been offered, you know, different release that I haven't taken. And he pulls out this Kelly and I was like, are you kidding? Like, I was in shock, I think. It's a Kelly. Like I am seeing a Kelly being pulled out that I can buy in Hermes. This hasn't happened to me. Like I've been trying to even just get a garden party all summer and I can't even get that. Like how am I getting a Kelly? And the fact that it was Cellier size 28, the exact size and style that I wanted for a Kelly, I was like, no, this doesn't happen. Like even when people get offered, like they want a 28, but they get a 25. I was actually this close to being like, no, it's not pink. I'm not gonna take it. And then I was like, wait a second. If I had a pink Kelly, and then I was getting offered another Kelly in the future, I would not say no to this color. I'm still hoping that I get a pink one day and I'm still gonna use and enjoy and love this Kelly. I got a Twilly to go with it, so I'll show you that now. And one thing I also wanna say is the first day we were in there, and I don't even know if this was told behind the scenes, but when we walked in, an SA was helping someone else and he walked by and he was like, I love your videos, by the way. I just wanted to tell you that. I think of myself still as a very small creator. That was shocking to me. And I was just like, oh, thank you. Like, I mean, he said it like in passing. So we didn't even get to have like a big conversation or anything. So this is the Twilly that I went for. I wanted something with blue, but with a lot of color. I do cut these tags out, but I don't have my small scissor with me and I don't want to ruin it. So I will do that when I get back home to Dubai. Mentioning that part of it, that someone who worked there did recognize me, but I don't know if that meant that, you know, the floor manager knew that, if he told her or what happened. Just for full transparency, maybe it could have been that I was recognized and that's why I got the Kelly offer. I don't know. I mean, I just hope that it was more so that like we bought across many different categories. She saw there was genuine interest in the brand. I did ask for a couple other things when we were shopping that they were just out of stock of, so she could see that I wanted to shop, you know, more from the brand. So I think in that interest could have just been that. So I don't know how the Hermes fairy works, but and I'm still in shock that, you know, I have a Kelly and I got offered it in store and it's my first Hermes bag that I bought in store and it's quota bag. Like, I still just really feel like maybe it's like imposter syndrome. Like, I'm just like, oh, I'm just not, you know, as big enough of a spender. Like, people who get offers in store, you know, buy a lot of stuff. I only buy what I like. Don't stick to the same SA, like, because I shop in, you know, different countries. I stick to the same SA within the country, but like I shop wherever I see the Hermes item that I want, I pick it up. Because if I ever wait and say like, oh, I'm gonna get it back in Dubai with my SA there, then they don't have it. So it's like, in terms of what everyone tells you for the journey, I don't do it properly. Like, I don't go in and I spend just to get an offer, because I just want to buy what I like and enjoy my items. But I hope that like sharing my story is helpful. I think the Hermes journey never goes as you would expect it to. So I'm super happy and super grateful, because I know this will be a beautiful bag that I will have for life. And the fact that it like did happen in New York on the trip, I'm always gonna remember that as well. So I really love actually that my offer didn't come from my home store and it didn't happen in Paris. So I'm not just giving you another video of I got my first quota bag or my quota bag in Paris. And I wanna know what you guys think about it. I will be doing a one in, one out with this situation because I do think that now that I have this blue, there's a Chanel or two that will be leaving my collection because I know I'm always gonna reach for this. I am super glad that this is palladium hardware and my other one is gold hardware, so it does make the bags feel different. They're different stitching styles, they're different sizes. I was going over in the store thinking like, are they too similar? Because you know, the bag is expensive, so I was like, I don't wanna duplicate. But even my love was like, no, take it. This is different enough. This is a beautiful color. Like, you're gonna use this just like you, you know, use your other multiple blue bags. I want you to also comment and tell me what you think I should name her, because she definitely needs a name. I'll share the prices with you now as well, because I know Hermes is really hard to find the prices. The ear cuff in US dollars is $285 plus tax. New York sales tax is 8.875%. The thing with the US is every state has different sales tax. So if you get your offer in Miami versus New York, maybe that will be different in the tax. So that's why I'm giving you the price of the item and the tax separately. For the belt, it's $545 for the belt. Our whole spend was a little bit under $3,000 for the other items that we bought. For the Twilly, it's $195 in the US plus tax. For the Kelly Cellier 28 Epsom leather with palladium hardware in the color Celeste, price was $11,200 plus tax. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll have more content coming with this Kelly in the future, I'm sure. But I just wanted to get this unboxing done here while I'm in New York so I could start using and enjoying the bag. Thank you guys so much for, you know, all of your wishes when I shared the little teaser over on my Instagram. You know, like, I buy things here and there, but I don't do the Hermes journey normally. So I think everyone was like, what happened? How did this happen? And it gives maybe a little hope that even if you're not spending one-to-one, you can still get an offer. And I just love that I can share this experience with you too, because it's so exciting for me and it's such a dream. And I can't believe it. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram and TikTok to see how I style this bag and all the rest of my bags. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye.